my life. And I want to be about telling other people about it. Promises of God, the rock on which I stand,
the truth to which I cling. Well, I became a Christian when I was about 10 years old. I remember being at a big Baptist church revival and the pastor talking about hell. Like, I just knew I was a bad kid. I just didn't behave very well. I just wasn't a very good kid. It made sense to me that someone else needed to be good on my behalf. You give and take away from my good, for who am I to say what I need, for you alone see the hidden parts of me that need to be stripped away. And as you begin, after my freshman year of college, I went on a mission trip to Mongolia, living in tents, telling people about Jesus. And I think that was the moment in time where I realized that being a Christian was really inviting Christ to be Lord of your life.
Of heights to the depths of the sea.
The song Indescribable, I wrote that probably 3 or 4 years ago. Picture me like driving down the interstate with one hand on the wheel and one hand like scribbling lyrics on like a bank receipt or something. Just the kind of day that makes you want to sing a song. And I was just speechless for a few minutes. And I thought about this idea of God truly being indescribable. Just coming up with all these words of Him being indescribable, uncontainable, unchangeable, incomparable, all these five-syllable words that I thought no one will ever be able to sing this in church. But it just was kind of my expression for just how amazing and how huge God is. All exclaiming, indescribable, uncontainable.
You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name.
The past year of our lives has definitely been the hardest. My husband Martin was diagnosed with a brain tumor. It was interesting having just never been in a place in my life where I was so out of control. Sitting beside his hospital bed when he was in the hospital for so long, and he'd always say, sing me that song about God's peace.
I will give you perfect.
Then he began to walk again, and after going through rehab, which we're still in the middle of, God just did a miracle. And when you're looking around at your life going, okay, did we get off track somewhere? Because this, whatever plan seemed to be there, it seems like it's derailed somehow. There's so many things in my life that I would have despaired if I hadn't believed that God was going to either deliver me or teach me something valuable about Himself through it. You know, we bless God because He is always good. Bless God because of who He is, not because of maybe how we feel at the moment. Sometimes we just need to bless Him. The hope of nations.